Connor, take it away.
I would love to. I was going to anyway. Hey, everybody, and welcome back to Inside Gaming Daily for Friday. Let me hear it.
Oh, it's Friday, baby.
My stars, Mr. Gar.
It's Friday. Time to get out of those clothes.
Come on. Speaking of sensual, sexy days.
Can't get enough of your games, babe.
Let's talk about Google Stadia. Can't stop being a trash fire, regardless of how many people make videos about our constant coverage of it.
Love y'all.
Can't stop this train from rolling. We're going to keep talking.
Strap in, baby birds. Mama's got some vomit for you. So yeah, mainly we're going to talk about Stadia's creative director, or the alleged creative director. We'll get to that later. They took the unique position of not trying to hype up their failing service, but instead going after streamers and really insulting them. It's a unique business strategy, to say
the least. Finally, somebody goes after the real villain.
The
independent content creator. So this all started with Twitch and their recent actions of deleting thousands of videos that contained copyrighted music. This obviously irked a lot of streamers who rightfully complained that they didn't get enough communication from Twitch. And furthermore, Twitch was like, yeah, you should probably go delete like any old videos that might have copyrighted music on them. Otherwise, you might get in more trouble. And it's just like, that is extremely vague from one of the most powerful companies on the planet. Yeah.
It's like all these services, when lawyers get involved, they're like, oh, this actually isn't our fault at all. And we're not going to protect you or help you in the slightest. So
we made a mistake by saying we'd support you. Mm-hmm. That was actually wrong. Oopsie.
So Alex Hutchinson, who claimed to be a creative director at Stadia, decided to go all in and side hard with Twitch. More than side with them. He took his own route with it.
So here's what he said. Streamers worried about getting their content pulled because they used music they didn't pay for should be more worried by the fact that they're streaming games they didn't pay for as well. It's all gone as soon as publishers decide to enforce it. Is he saying that streamers all stole their games? I don't...
Okay, so this is where he goes completely fucking hog wild. He said the real truth is the streamers should be paying the developers and publishers of the games they stream. They should be buying a license like any real business and paying for the content they use.
I like a guy that looks at the way like music and like all of entertainment works and says, we need more of that. We need more restrictive law.
This is the guy who reminded the teacher that they forgot to give us a quiz.
Yeah.
Like that. You're siding with the big guy here over the rest of us. It's hilarious because I guess he's implying that streamers don't pay for their games, or I guess he's saying they should be paying for a license for everything they stream. A weird position for a streaming service to take. I'm just saying. Go ask the guys who made Fall Guys what they think about streamers and whether they think it helped their game or not.
Yeah.
Obviously, streamers did not take this tweet very well. Dr. Disrespect quote tweeted Hutchinson and added, probably more than a little sarcastically, that he is the creative director for Google Stadia.
It was kind of like creative director of Stadia, ladies and gentlemen. And the streamer Dakotas responded to Hutchinson in the understatement of the year saying, you're going to regret this tweet. And they did. Yes.
Even an economics professor weighed in, nerd, calling it an unbelievably terrible take. Alan Nahaz Bester wrote that there is absolutely no support for it in any formal or even coherent economic reasoning. And no empirical support beyond edge cases like previous gen Nintendo.
Go off, King.
He added, I would challenge this person to give a single example of a case of streamers extracting rents that would otherwise accrue to game developers.
Yes, Alan!
Leave some for his family to bury. It's also extra hilarious considering that in July, Stadia began a limited test of live streaming games to, of course, YouTube. But I guess those streamers should be paying a licensing fee to do that. Stadia probably just added it to their bill.
Why is he siding with the competition?
I think he was just trying to actually, and it
He does actually seem pretty smart and hot now that I think about it. Plus, there are tons of games like Among Us and Fall Guys who owe their popularity to the fact that lots of people streamed it.
Among Us was out for 2 years before it.
Yeah.
Took out. Like, yeah. We have a daily on. I don't want to ruin
it. Yeah.
Later, Hutchinson tried to put it behind him, tweeting, "Anyway, gonna hop online and stream some Fall Guys. Who's up for it?" Oh! What?
Did he buy his license?
I hope
to stream. Yeah, and he paid for that Jonah Hill gif that he used, yeah. Right?
But anyway, it was hilarious. Everybody online had a lot of fun goofing on Stadia. Really, it went the entire day. So congrats to Stadia for finally getting some publicity. Y'all made it. No such thing as bad publicity.
Big ups.
There was lots of bad publicity to be had.
Streamer King Gothalian wrote, "A lot of people quote tweeting this hot take about how streamers should need a license for publishers to stream their games. I think we should be more concerned that anyone that works at Google Stadia is giving business advice."
King, go off! But the all-time best windmill dunk came after Alex Navarro, a senior editor at Giant Bomb, quote tweeted Hutchison and wrote, "Speaking of things people don't want to pay for, how's Stadia going?"
To which Hutchinson replied, "Better than Giant Bomb, from what I can tell." So tried to zing
he
him back.
Fired back.
Yeah. Tried to fire back, and then someone named Robert Fala Levette came in with a tactical nuke, replying, "At least Giant Bomb works on a Chromecast."
That's awesome. That's so funny. Boom! We will talk more about Stadia trending for all the wrong reasons, but first, let's talk about cats. They're great, right? Except for one thing, the litter box. Well, now there's a solution for that, and it's our sponsor, the Kitty Poo Club.
Today's episode of Inside Gaming Daily is brought to you by Kitty Poo Club. Ooh, baby, this is a good one today. Listen, are you like me? Are you a proud cat person? I got two of them. You love your cat, but that does not mean you love having a litter box in your home. It's the worst. Kitty Poo Club takes care of the more unpleasant parts of cat ownership, so you can go back to just loving your furry friend. Working from home, you know, you got more time for your morning coffee, a little afternoon nap, you know, maybe opportunities for your cat to walk across the keyboard in the middle of a Zoom call. In my case, my cat has completely shut down my computer twice, I think, but you don't want to be around the litter box at all, ever. It is an all-in-one litter box solution designed to be convenient for you. Every month, they deliver an affordable, high-quality, recyclable litter box that is pre-filled with the litter of your choice. They're leak-proof, eco-friendly, and have a fun design for every season. Ooh. When the month is up, you just recycle the box. Kitty Poo Club will automatically deliver a new one to you. No changing used litter, no more cleaning the box. You can customize your order based on how many cats you have, what type of litter they prefer, because they do have preferences, believe it or not, to where they poop. It's got a no-risk guarantee. You can easily customize or cancel anytime. Right now, Kitty Poo Club is giving you 20% off your first order when you set up auto ship by going to kittypooclub.com. It's a great website name. And entering promo code INSIDE. kittypooclub.com, promo code INSIDE. That's 20% off when you set up auto ship. Again, that is kittypooclub.com. Don't forget to enter the promo code INSIDE at checkout. Thank you, Kitty Poo Club, for sponsoring today's show.
Okay, back to Stadia and their terrible week. Suffice to say, this was bad publicity that Stadia really doesn't need right now. Not that they ever do, but they're obviously not doing great. But they have been trying to take the initiative lately, shift the narrative a little bit.
Yeah, they've been doing a string of announcements this week of various new games and demos coming to the beleaguered service. Most recently, they announced that the demo of Ubisoft's action game Immortals Fenyx Rising was available for free on Stadia before it launches in December.
Over on the Stadia subreddit, fans the service were furious at Hutchinson's timing. One post summed it up succinctly, posting a screenshot of his tweet and saying, "Ah yes, making people hate Stadia in new ways. Thanks, Alex." And we do have our M. Night Shyamalan style twist in the script.
Yes, Hutchinson is not the creative director of Stadia. He is the creative director of a studio in Montreal that's owned by Stadia, and you better believe that he updated his bio real quick, like after all the controversy broke.
Oh my god.
He's going to be updating a lot of things very soon.
Yeah,
I feel
the resume.
Like. Not surprisingly, Google immediately distanced itself from Hutchinson's comments. A spokesperson told 9to5 Google, "The recent tweets by Alex Hutchinson," and they made sure to add, "creative director at the Montreal studio of Stadia Games and Entertainment, do not reflect those of Stadia, YouTube, or Google."
He's not with us. Well, I mean, okay, he is. He doesn't speak for us, though, and he's not in the capacity that he implied.
Hey, I know you're trying to keep this party chill, but like, my brother's staying with me. I mean, like, he'll just stay in the corner.
And then he shows up and is like doing coke in the bathroom.
Yeah, and he's taking
long.
A on the kitchen floor, yeah, and he's just like pushing people off balconies.
Yeah,
like,
just don't mention Ron doors. Paul, and he's fine.
YouTube gaming boss Ryan Wyatt also backed far, far away from Hutchinson, tweeting, "We believe that publishers and creators have a wonderful symbiotic relationship that has allowed a thriving ecosystem to be created, one that has mutually benefited everyone. YouTube is focused on creating value for creators, publishers, and users. All ships rise when we work together." That's clever, though. Did he just make that last part up?
Yeah, that's an original. That's a Google
original. Did he just come up with that?
But that's the thing. Like, streamers don't hurt games at all. It's free advertising. It's free. It's like hours and hours of free advertising. Yes, there are streamers who make a shitload of money, definitely more than the devs who made the game. But that does not take away the fact that they are helping hype whatever game they're playing.
Esports entrepreneur Landon Hammerly underscored that point, posting side-by-side screenshots of Among Us. One was last year versus this year when everybody started streaming it, and it had gone up like 1,000,000%. Yep. He wrote above it, "Streamer don't play game versus streamer play game. Pay streamer."
Even Stadia has announced a number of features that are related to streaming, like crowd play, which lets players jump into a multiplayer game with their favorite streamers and YouTubers. Google sees the value of streaming. This has been part of the plan since day one, because it's integrating it into their service. But, you know, there's always going to be someone who shoots their mouth off. And in Stadia's case, it came at a pretty bad time. I mean, this is the thing about gamers.
This guy just seems like he was sitting at home getting angry.
Yes.
Reading something. I don't know what.
Right.
He thought he was just going to set the rubes straight on
this. Yeah, exactly.
All these people are going after this company. How dare they?
Have a good weekend. We love you.
Bye.
Well, no, we appreciate you.
We do. Just don't stream our videos without paying us first, please.
We will get the lawyers on your ass.
You got to pay the Inside Gaming license if you want to watch this.
We're extremely litigious.
Right. Welcome to Inside Gaming. I'm Brian. It's the weekend roundup. So we've written a lot about Google Stadia as it approaches its first birthday next month and how new competitors like Amazon Luna and xCloud, they're either drawing near or xCloud, it's here. It's the future is now. Some of Stadia's most loyal fans have been